Maybe I should put my hair
out. And... Oh, wait, no, hold on. They say, in Hollywood, they say 3, 2, 1, and... What is going on, you guys? Brandon here, aka Brawadis. And today, I'm here with my beautiful girlfriend, Jacqueline. Introduce yourself.
Hi, guys. I'm Jacqueline.
Guys, you know, I never noticed how many people actually love Jackie until we go out and we meet a bunch of supporters. And so many of them freak out over Jackie. I love it. It's funny.
Thank you guys for loving me more than him, clearly.
So today's video is actually going to be a story time. This story was highly requested ever since me and my boy Ali did the Truth or Drink. There was a question in the Truth or Drink that read, have you ever been caught by the cops having sex? Wait, hold on. That just sounded wrong. Have you ever been caught having sex by the cops? I don't know why.
Isn't that the same thing?
I know, but when I said, have you ever been caught by the cops having sex? I don't know. Okay. Either way, me and Ali, you know, we both answered that question. And my answer to that was, yes, I have been caught by the cops. However, that video was not a story time video. So, you know, we just moved on to the next question. And ever since that day, you guys have been killing me on Twitter. I've been getting tweets every single day. Tell us a story. Tell us a story. Tell us a story. So today, me and Jackie, you know, we're just laying in bed. I'm like, babe, I don't have a video for tomorrow, you know. You want to just tell the story? And at first we were
I said, hell no.
Yeah, at first we were hesitant. We're like, you know, we don't want to tell it. We don't want to. But at the same time, it's just funny. Like, this isn't something that happens to people on a daily basis.
Don't take it seriously. Like, we're whatever.
Funny things happen
yes. to us all the time. Together.
Yeah, we just always get ourselves into sticky situations. So if this is the first video you're watching on us, you're probably like, oh, that's weird. But if you guys know us, you know we always find a way to just get into sticky situations. Yeah. So people who watch this and know us are going to be like, of course, Brandon and Jackie, of course. So without further ado, we decided, you know, it would be a funny story to tell. And we're ready to tell you guys. So, you know, me and Jackie, we were, just starts us on a date. It's not bad.
Oh, yeah. So, okay, I forgot about that.
Me and Jackie, you forget about the date part because what happened after the date was so.
Wait, say where we went on a date, though.
Okay, we went to the beach. I know, you guys want me to say movies. Jackie wishes I said we went to the movies.
So bad. Still, can I just... put disclaimer
okay, just
here.
Tell them I've never...
We haven't gone to the movies and we've been dating since.
Guys, I don't like going to the movie theaters. If I'm spending that much time looking at a TV, I'd rather watch a basketball game. But we'll go one day. We'll go one day.
Whatever. Maybe on my birthday.
Maybe on your 50th birthday.
Get Jackie to the movies on my birthday.
Not a regular birthday. 50th birthday. No. Guys, let's keep it going. So we were at the beach, you know, just hanging out. I don't know. Maybe got some ice cream. Just walked around.
We were eating, remember?
Yeah, we were eating, just walking around the ocean. And you know, for everybody out there who's in a relationship, whether you're a boyfriend or girlfriend, you guys know that when you go on a date, you know, you kind of get, you get turned on. You're just looking at your significant other for so long and you guys are hanging out, you know, just having a good time. Oh, girl, yeah, you know. And
first
you guys are...
That's not how you touch me, you fucking liar. He goes like this.
So you know, you know you're just flirting throughout the day, so you get kind of turned on. And regular people, you know, after a date they go home and then, you know, one thing leads to another and boom, before you know it, you're in there. That's regular people. For us, so we finished the day and, you know, we're on our way back home, but the beach is like here and then my house is like all the way like here, so it's like- kind of like a 20-minute drive.
No,
it's
like 20.
Like a 20-minute drive.
At the time, it felt like an hour.
Yeah, so, you know, to us, 20 minutes is a long time. And so, you know, we're in the car and we're just like...
flirting.
Yeah, we're flirting and we're like, honestly, 20 minutes, no, that's way too long. Let's just, you know, find a place and just kick it in the backseat, you know, just hang out in the backseat of my car. And
we really hung out that day, yeah.
Yeah, we really hung out, like hung out of the pants.
Wait, don't say like that.
Okay. Oh, well, hold on, I will talk about it. Nice. So, and keep in mind, guys, when we say we went to the beach, it's not during the day, because for those who know, I do all my YouTube stuff during the day. So this was at night, late at night, like 9 or 10 p.m. So we had gone to the beach at like 9 or 10 p.m. But at this point, driving back home, it's probably midnight or 1 in the morning. And, you know, we're driving around the area and I find this spot. And we're so dumb because I actually drove so far to find the spot.
We might as well just went
to the damn house. But I don't know. We were just
spur
whatever.
Spur of the moment being adventurous. And obviously, it did not work in our favor.
So. You know, young love. It was like a couple months ago, so we were very young. We didn't understand.
Young love. You're literally the same age.
No, guys, so, you know, I'm driving back, and if we're being honest, it took me like 30 minutes to actually find the spot, so I'm an idiot for that, but we find the spot, and it's actually really close to my house. But anyways, we find the spot, and it's like... It looks like an abandoned parking garage. I don't know. It looks weird, but it's all dark except there's like a little light and nobody's there. It's like a two-story parking garage and it's just a weird place. But I'm like, okay, you know what? This will do. So, you know, we're just chilling and I play my playlist. Remember the Usher?
I have a dirty version of the sex playlist.
So I start playing it and, you know, one thing leads to another. We're in the backseat and we finish a round. A round is done. We're done. Okay, you know, we're just chilling. Okay, fine. Talk about it nicely. We made love for one round of, you know, intercourse and a lot of kissing because that's what passionate, you know, it was very passionate and intimate like this. Hey. No.
Like this.
Okay, fine. Like this.
No.
Okay, guys. Anyways, so we finished one round and, you know, normal people, they don't get too greedy. You know, they go around and then they go back home and, you know, the day's over. But me, I'm a firm believer in
two.
If you have time, it's an endless amount. I mean, if you're in a rush, yes, yeah. I'm a believer in just one round, get it done, and then go do what you have to do. But if it's midnight or 1 a.m. and you have time to spend, you know, one round, two round, three round, four, it does, you know, you might as well.
At that time, we thought it was a good idea to, like, stay there longer than
That's
we should.
That's what I'm saying. So,
like, I was just like, I need to, like, you know.
No, guys, so we finish a round, okay? Like I said, normal people, they go home, whatever. But us, we're just chilling, you know. All my guys out there, you know, you can't go one round and another back to back. You have to have a little bit of a waiting period. And of course, hold on before I keep going. When I say make love and intimate and stuff, obviously to the girl you plan on marrying. You can't just go out there and have sexual intercourse with, you know, random people. It has to be the one you plan on marrying. So,
Very safe. First of all, don't laugh because I know why you're laughing.
You must have very, very safe sex. If we're being honest, I myself did not use a condom, but everybody else you must use a condom.
Yeah, he does.
You just lied to almost 2 million people. Okay, guys.
Don't say that.
Anyways, so, you know, we're getting ready. Round two. We're about to go in. I'm naked.
No, don't be vulgar.
Okay, how can I tell this story without being vulgar?
Because you have to say, and then...
Okay, so I took...
My beautiful girlfriend looked at me, and I just wanted to...
Okay, so my beautiful girlfriend looked at me, and at that point, I was like, okay, it's time for round two.
Yeah.
So, you know, I retook my clothes off, and, you know, she's, like, took the clothes off as well. And, you know, very carefully, very sexy, took the clothes
off.
Very
romantic.
And so, you know, I'm doing the, you know, the starter to get the waterfall going. Yeah, the tease to start the Niagara Falls.
The waterfall had
already been started, but you needed to get to Niagara Falls. So, you know, I'm doing my work and I'm about to go in and I see like a car parked right behind me and all the lights were off. But I don't know how I saw it. I just saw like a car pull in. And the lights were off, and so I'm like, what the fuck? And I stopped what I was doing, but I was still naked. And then my friend right here, my girlfriend, she was also not wearing any clothes.
Your friend.
You're my girlfriend and my best friend. And then the lights turn on. I don't mean the red and blue and white. I don't mean that. I mean the really, really bright
the lights. The fucking light that you know.
You know you're screwed at that point.
That light.
And at that point, you know, her Niagara Falls turned into the Sahara Desert. It was like... like dry, and I was like, fuck. Like,
first of all.
And me, I went from like ruler to like fucking deflated balloon, like just that. And I was like, fuck, it's a cup. And so, you know, I started putting my clothes on. You know, mine is easy. I always wear basketball shorts, so I just slipped on my basketball shorts. That was easy. But her, she has the jeans and all that, so it's harder for her to get her clothes on.
Oh, man.
And so, thank God this was when I had my Lexus, not my BMW. So the back windows were fully tinted. And so the cop comes up, knocks on the window, and it's fully tinted. So I could see him, but he can't really see me. And I'm like, what am I supposed to do? The car is off, so I can't roll the window down. But I feel like if I open the door, he's gonna shoot me because you're not supposed to just, you know, open the door. But I took my chances. I'm like, whatever, if I die, I die. And I open the door slowly and I'm like, okay, you know,
I'm
stepping out.
Puts his hands
because
up.
I didn't know.
He's like, okay, I'm coming out with my hands.
I had both hands up and I'm like, am I, like, I don't have anything on me. Am I allowed to come out? And he kind of peeks in and he turns away. And I'm like, sir, hold on. And so I came out, hands up, and he steps back. And he's like, is someone else in the car? And I said, yes. And he's like, is she covered? What did he say? He said, no, like, is she?
He said, is she covered all the way? And you were like.
And I peeked back. No, so she's putting her clothes on. And he goes, is she covered all the way? And I didn't know if she had her clothes on or not. So I'm like this. And I went, I peeked back inside. The door is like cracked open. I peeked back to him and I was like, no, she's not. And I'm like, can I please tell her to put her clothes on so she doesn't have to come out naked? And he's like, yeah, tell her to stay in until she has all her clothes on and then for her to step out. So first of all, at this point, I'm shitting myself. I've, like, aside from getting a speeding ticket, I've never had an encounter with the cops where I'm out of my car and, you know, face to face with an officer. I've never had this type of experience. And I watch a lot of cops, like, on TV. So I'm like, fuck. What's, like, where's the camera? Am I gonna be on Cops Reloaded? Like, what's going on? And so, you know, Jackie's getting her clothes on and I'm talking to the cop. And I told him, the first thing I said was, officer, are you gonna be taking down, like, am I getting a ticket? Are you gonna be taking down my information? And he said, the reason I came here is not because I saw your car or because someone called. Actually, the reason I came here is because this area is actually really high and drug activity, and there's a lot of drug deals and a lot of people that do drugs over here, so the cops usually come by and you know,
check
the area. And he looked at me and he goes, now from what I see, you weren't doing drugs. However, you were, like, you know, he was trying to tell me, you know, you were fucking, I mean you were having intimate sex.
No, he actually, I'm sure he said, and keep in mind, you guys, I can't hear anything because Brandon and him literally stepped super
he
far
told me
away
to come here
from the car. So I'm like, oh, we're so fucked right now. And I'm like thinking, oh my God, oh man.
And so, you know, he goes, yeah, the only reason I came is not because I saw you guys or because someone called. It's because a lot of people do drugs here. So we came to check. And me being the dumbass that I am, first of all, I didn't even have my shirt on. I just had my basketball shorts on. So imagine some skinny bone Joan Twig is standing there at like 2 a.m, middle of the night, facing a cop after getting caught having sex. He knew what we were doing. He was like, obviously you guys aren't doing drugs, but you know, you're not doing something. Yeah, you're not doing something that's okay to be doing. And I was like, I know, I'm sorry. And then I decide to crack a joke. And I said, well, officer, you know, I'm not saying we were right, but at least we weren't doing drugs. And I'm, you know, I'm waiting for him to laugh. Okay, no laugh. And I was just like, oh, sorry, officer. So.
And he's fucking.
He's gonna like, kill me.
And he looks at me again and he's like, come here, come here.
She didn't
I
hear.
I was so scared. I did not want to get out.
No, really, I was embarrassed. I'm standing there like, Jackie's still in the car, so it was just me and the cop, and it was an older cop, of course. And I'm standing there without a shirt, you know, my big loose basketball shorts, a skinny twig, skinny bone Jones twig. And I'm in my head, I'm like, did you see anything? Or hopefully this guy didn't see anything, because, you know, I don't want him to be jealous. Yeah, so I told her, I was like, come here, if you have your clothes out, come here. So she comes out and
I'm like, my mom's gonna beat my ass.
Yeah, he, at this point, I didn't know if, like, if it was illegal, or at this point, I didn't know if we were gonna get a ticket. At this point, the only thing he had said was, we came because we thought people were doing drugs, and it turns out you're not doing drugs, but you are still doing something bad. Then I tried to crack the fucking joke like an idiot. Then he didn't laugh. So at this point, I didn't know, am I gonna get a ticket or no? Then he asks for my ID. And at that point, I was like, fuck, I'm screwed. Like, there's the DUI system, there's, you know, the sex offender system, and then there's probably a system for getting caught having sex in the middle of the night in your car. And I knew for sure I was going in that system. And I was like, shit, what am I gonna tell my mom? You know, how much is the ticket? Am I gonna go to jail? All this stuff. And he asked for my ID, and he's taking it down. Then he asked for Jackie's ID.
And he's like, are you sure you're 18? Because I have to make sure that you're not 18. And I'm like, yes.
So he tells us that he's not going to give us a ticket. But he did take my name down. So like
everything,
I said, I didn't get a ticket. But I'm sure there's some secret system with the FBI called idiots caught having sex in their car. And I'm sure mine and Jackie's. Yeah, they probably make fun of us. So I'm sure mine and Jackie's name is on some sort of list.
Dumbass,
I don't know what list.
Dumbass 2.
Yeah, dumbass 1 and 2. And so surprisingly, he lets us go. And, you know, he told us if we plan on doing something like this, not to be doing. He said it's just dangerous.
Yeah.
He said especially over here. He was actually really nice, so shout out to him. I forgot his name.
I'm sure he'll find this.
Yeah, I'm sure he'll come across this video somehow. Thank you so much for letting us go. And also, he was nice. He said, I'm trying to look out for you guys. This is a dangerous area with a lot of drugs. I didn't know that. I should have just went to my damn house. But
yeah, right there.
So I thanked him. I was like, thank you so much, officer. We won't be doing this again. And you know, we get back in the car. We're round 2 right there. No, I'm just joking. We definitely did not do that.
You would think we would learn our lesson, but we didn't.
No, okay.
It fucking happened again.
Oh, yeah, yeah, no. We have, okay, for a separate story time, if you guys leave, how many likes? If we get, I want 50,000 likes on this video, and then we'll tell part two about how we've been caught by cops again. But that one's very, like, too descriptive, so I don't know. Okay, let's make it 100,000 likes. 100,000.
Yeah.
Because that one is very, like...
And, like, many things happened at that time. Actually, like, that story would be way, way, way longer than this one. I'm sweating right now.
But no, guys, honestly, so after the cop left, we get back in the car and we're like, because... all my guys out there, you guys know what blue balls is, right? It's, I don't need to explain it. If you know what it is, you know what it is. If you don't, then just go look it up. And I was scared. I told Jackie, I was like, you know, we were about to go in and I didn't get to go in. So, you know, should I just go really quick? Should we just finish really quick?
I said, hell no.
She's like, no. She's like, we just got caught by the damn cops. And I was like, okay, fine. Honestly, I'm stupid and crazy, but I'm not that crazy. So let's just go back home.
We actually got lucky that I said that because once we were pulling out, the cop was
still
waiting,
there.
Like waiting until we left. But
he was waiting for us to get out.
He was waiting outside so that we could go out and he was falling.
Oh my God. Imagine if you caved in and... Like, because I wanted to go around to him after the cop came.
Come on, dude. You're not going to come back.
No, you got to use this tactic. Come on. No, guys, but just imagine if I went back in, like, inside. Not inside my car or inside the house. I mean, in, like, in, like that. Just imagine the cop comes. What do you think the cop would say? The cop would be in shock. He would say, are you fucking kidding me right now? Didn't I just give you guys a warning? No, but we didn't, so... Shout out to the cop for being so nice.
I think he followed us though. Or
no,
like,
he probably secretly saw you putting your clothes back on. God turned on. He's like, oh, I need to follow them. I need to see what's up.
No.
Officer, if you did see that. But anyways, so yeah, guys, I guess we never really wanted to tell this story, but then we thought about it. We're like, as vulgar and embarrassing as it is, it's also just as funny. And like I said, you guys have been killing me. Please make the story time video. Please make the story time video. And what is this YouTube channel for? It's for what you guys want to see. The videos are for your eyes to watch. So we decided to tell this story. And honestly, it's just young love. I'm 21, she's 20. We're gonna have stupid situations like this. And if you guys know Brandon Awadis and Jackie Figueroa, then you know we have even more stupid, you know, situations that we put ourselves into
all
the time. We do it more than the regular human being. I don't know why we're like that, but we just are.
We are just like, not bad luck, but like, if we were to tell you the things that happened to me and him,
it's
like,
just
you would
crazy.
Actually, like, you would be surprised that we're still here, like, alive and
knock
live
on
and on
wood.
Stereo, like Hannah Baker.
Knock on wood. Ah! Anyways, guys, thank you so much for stopping by and watching this video. I hope you really did enjoy it. Remember, safe sex only, and only have sex with the people that you plan on marrying.
Yeah.
But if you do plan on marrying like 6 or 7 people, then go for it. That's what I'm gonna say. But not me. I'm saying for other people.
Yeah.
Get out of what you're kicking me out of my own room.
Yes.
Nah, guys, really, thank you
Brandon
so much for watching.
Away.
I don't get carried away.
Yeah, he like gets turned on and then it's like, man, what can he do to me?
I would have been turned on, but right before this video is over.
Stop.
So, thank you so much for watching this video. I really do appreciate you guys watching. Road to 2 mil is still on. We're less than 150,000 subscribers away. So I have no idea when I'm going to hit it, but I do know it's creeping up and I'm really nervous. I'm really excited. I'm really anxious. I don't know what this feeling is. And I haven't even hit 2 million yet. I can't even imagine when I actually do hit 2 million. It's just going to be crazy. Honestly, when I hit 2 million, do you want to go back to a place and
we should do it. Do you guys realize?
She did not learn her lesson. I love Devin Booker. He shouted me out when he was playing Call of Duty on Twitch. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. And I love you guys all.
Bye, guys.
Peace out. 8-Town Down. Do you know that song?
Okay.
Yeah, Usher. He says Usher. Okay, bye, guys. Oh, and by the way, if you do plan on having, you know, in a car, please don't get caught by the cops because it's very, very embarrassing and scary.
More embarrassing. And you actually could be, like,
pronounced
a sex offender. Depends where it is.
Yes.
Like,
oh, we shouldn't even stop.
Yeah. Like,
don't even tell the story. That's a different... No, that story is never going to be on YouTube. The one in...
Oh. Oh, no.
No, guys.
Yeah, I just... I'm leaving.
No, hold on. Wait.
Just don't be us, you guys.
Yeah, don't be us. That's the rule. That's the
advice that we could give you. You could watch us and laugh at us, but just don't be us.
Don't be us, trust me. It's for your own safety and for your own health and good. Do not be a Brandon or a Jackie. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Bye, guys.
Ew, am I the ugliest thing I've ever seen?
No, now it is. Oh, and by the way, for anybody saying, oh, you guys are dirty, you guys are like whores or whatever. No, this was just, we were dating, it wasn't when we first met each other, when we first started talking. This was well into our relationship.